Our Commitment 2012 coverage continues now with a focus on the race in the 104th State House District. The 104th covers northern Dauphin County. Republican Sue Helm has represented the district since 2007, and she is seeking another term. Her challenger in this race is Democrat Chris Dietz. He's a mechanical engineer for a company that manufactures printing presses, and we welcome you both here today. Thanks for being here. Chris, why do you want to run for this seat?
I want to run for this seat because it's important to me that we've got quality education going forward in Pennsylvania. It's also important to me that we've got flourishing jobs in the area, as well as a lot of issues need tackled as far as government reform goes across the district.
Such as?
Well, I think that we've got a lot of work to do on redistricting reform. It's been in the courts all year long this year. I think that the automatic raises that the legislature enjoys are out of touch with the majority of Pennsylvanians. And I also am a fan of campaign finance limits and term limits as well.
Now, if their redistricting, which we have said is still in the courts, would change, your district would then include a portion of Lebanon County. You both don't like the idea of how your district would change.
No, I think the way the district is now serves the people very well. Like, it's easy to get to, it's compact, the people know where my offices are. It's going to be a major expense also, because my office in Elizabethville will be redistricted right out of the district, so I'll have to move that office. So right now the people are very content with what I do for them, and I really want to keep the district as it is.
So what do you think, Representative Helm, you have accomplished personally, other than, yes, you passed a budget along with the other legislators, but you, what has been your priority that you feel like you have accomplished in two terms?
Well, you know, everybody in the legislature, we all have our nick. And I did go in with a real estate background. So when I first went in office, there was a parcel of land that was supposed to go to PSCCU. They were hoping to obtain that piece of ground. It was kind of stymied in the House of Representatives. So I figured out how to do that land transfer. And now, before they were thinking possibly of going to Cumberland County, I kept 300 jobs in Dauphin County, and there's probably going to be another 200 added. So we all have our areas of expertise. But I have reached out to the people. The people know that they can come to me, they can work with me, and a medical facility has always been a number one priority of mine. I'm having difficulty getting that to happen, but I'll never give up with it. I think the Medic 6 has stepped up what they've done. The Evelyn Frederick Center, they were thinking about moving. I talked to Pinnacle Health. You know, they're planning to stay now, even though they'd like to reach out and expand. So there's many things that I've worked with in the district to think keep things going and really help the people that live in the 104th district.
And Chris, how do you think, with your background, you would represent the people in this district?
Well, as an engineer, a mechanical engineer, I'm a problem solver. We, you know, identify a problem, figure out a way to address it, and then implement those ways to address the issue. And I'm also president of Borough Council in Millersburg, so I have some municipal legislative experience already under my belt, and I feel that we've done some great things locally in Millersburg that I hope to take that knowledge with me to the State House when I get elected and get sworn in January.
You mentioned legislative pay raise. What about the size of the legislature? There's been renewed talk about reducing the size and possibly even, you know, a part-time legislature. What's your take on that?
Well, I'm interested in the discussion. But I'm concerned that in some areas, like across the northern part of Pennsylvania, we already have very large districts that include a couple counties. And if we change the legislature, the number of representatives, into half maybe, instead of 203 down to 100 or 150, that's going to increase the size of those districts. And I'm not really sure that we're going to save money, because the same number of constituent offices are going to have to be required to represent the people. So the districts get larger, the number of offices pretty much stay the same. The only cost that we're going to really save is the salaries of a few legislators.
Plus per diems. Like, I have signed on to two different bills to reduce the size of the legislature. And I think it's going to be awakening to us, because just like the schools, when we cut the funding for schools, now we put it back in the budget, so they really didn't get cut. But I think now schools are starting to step up to the plate and look how they can maybe partner with private people to bring education, like, better into the schools. So I'm all for cutting the size of the legislature. I think that we could do it. We could do it efficiently. With modern technology now and emails and everything we do electronically, it's a different world now than it used to be. So I am signed on to both bills. It's going to take a long time for it to happen, though. I mean, it's not going to happen overnight.
Speaking of schools, what about funding schools? You know, lots of talk about property tax reform. What's your view on that?
Well, in the last 18 months, I was on a property tax elimination or reduction form. And we came up with four different property tax bills. Now what we have done is turned it over to another group. The committee I was on was strictly Republicans. Now we've turned it over to Democrats and Republicans, and what their task is, look at these four different bills, come up with a really good, solid bill, and present it to us by November 30th.
From my perspective, $1 billion was cut from public education in the last fiscal year. That has not been restored. In fact, today there is $7 million less in our public school districts in the 104th district because of the budget that was passed by the legislature. I don't know what restoration has taken place, but that's the deficit that we're at right now. I am interested in property tax reform. I think it would be a great thing, but the devil's in the details. And my opponent, Representative Helm, she is supporting House Bill 1776, which that is the goal to eliminate property taxes. But in the details of that, the report from the state government shows that in the first year, there will be $1.5 billion revenue shortfall for schools. So that's another hit to our public education system. And it only continues to grow from there. It also shows that middle class taxpayers will have $550 million more to cover because they won't be able to write off their property taxes in their federal income tax. So there's a lot of issues. I mean, it also expands sales tax to things like American flags, caskets. You know, there will be literally a death tax if this gets passed. Like I said, I really like the idea of eliminating property taxes or reducing them, but, you know, I haven't seen a bill so far that is going to do it in a good way for our schools as well as Pennsylvania.
And that I agree with. That's why I said there was four bills. We're not going to run any of those bills. That's why we have another task force to come up with a different idea. I will also say that when I knock on doors, people still talk about property tax elimination. The realtors across Pennsylvania are a very forceful group, and they are coming up. They're working very hard to come up with a better idea that they will present to the legislature. Because I just talked to them recently, and I said how, you know, property tax really doesn't seem to be going away, and they said, like, we're going to work with this. And believe me, if they want to get an idea across, they will get it across. So I'm looking forward to what all the realtors of Pennsylvania have to come and tell us.
All right.
I would also add that we have to realize that homeowners are not the only people that pay property taxes. So if we eliminate property taxes, corporations like Walmart won't be paying them anymore. So the middle class property owners are going to be the ones that are going to have to foot the bill. So, you know, going forward, we need to be really cognizant of the mix of taxes that we're looking at. I'm in favor of trying to increase the farmstead homestead exemption funds as well as the property rebate funds that help seniors. I think that's the better way to go, and it kind of was started with the gaming monies, went into that. Granted, a lot more were supposed to go into it,
right.
They haven't. But I think we can work to bolster those numbers that will help reduce property taxes for, you know, primary homeowners going forward.
All right, very good. Well, I want to thank you both, the two candidates for the 104th State House District in Pennsylvania. We appreciate you being here and joining us.
All right.